used to it now.
She's used to it.
Yeah.
How many years you guys been married?
33. Going on 33.
Years, that's awesome,
yeah, 34 man. Going on. Yeah.
Wow,
thank you.
Blessing. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. So, dude, how you doing, man?
I'm hanging in there, man. Another
so,
day in D.C.
I didn't want to bring you to this grease pit, but here we are.
Oh, yeah, Eddie's Tomaine Tavern and Grease Pit. Yeah,
yes. Now, how's your heart? Because I don't want you to die before we...
Well, whatever I eat, it'll be good, but it'll do my heart any good.
You die with a smile. Person. See that?
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
Cliff, man, you're not going to believe. You're not going to believe what I read.
Go ahead. I can believe it.
Well...
You read it, yeah.
There's this article, man, from the Georgetown Law Review.
Okay.
Talks about America under surveillance.
Oh,
now, I know you one of those cats, you know.
Come on, let's assume.
They surveil everybody else,
yeah,
not you.
Yeah, everybody. You know. I mean, I've given up on that a long time ago.
It's, you just assume it's baked in.
Of course, of course.
You know, I wonder if we've got anybody in this country who still believes, like, they could be off the grid. Like,
well, they believe it because they try it. But, I mean, they got satellites, man. The satellites.
Watching this,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, they got satellites. 30 years ago, I remember Gorbachev complaining the Americans had satellites that could read license plate numbers,
yes, sir,
off cars.
Yes,
they
sir.
Can do that.
And that was years ago. So today, we're in a whole different realm.
Oh, they know.
I'm just wondering, like...
Big Brother's watching.
Big Brother's watching. I wonder if everyone has that feeling, like, that surveillance is a real deal. And it might be some interesting ideas and things that people think on the street. I'm wondering what the man on the street thinks.
I'm
if we
sure
think
they
this
think
way.
About it.
Okay, let's see.
So I really don't have any problem with the surveillance part.
I am quite concerned about the heightened level of surveillance that we're finding through the products that are made available to us.
I think that there is reason to be concerned about how much surveillance we're experiencing.
So these people are concerned, and we are talking about it here. So I'm wondering, there's got to be like some legitimate reasons for surveillance.
Of course there is. Of course there is. You know how many crimes have been solved,
yes,
because the cameras are,
yes,
there?
Yes.
I mean, people's lives have been saved.
I actually heard about one of those.
Yeah, of course they're all over the place.
Amazon Echo, this guy.
Oh, yeah.
Gets in a drunken fit and kills somebody, and it's recorded by the Amazon Echo.
I know, but on the
and
other
they bring
hand,
it back.
My wife was all so excited a couple of years. Oh, I got this thing, and you just put it.
Yeah.
Oh,
I think
great.
Your wife is my wife.
Great.
Same
so
thing.
We got it, and then so she would use it. Hey, what's the recipe
for such and such?
How do you get the yarn?
Play me a song.
Or order me this, and it was great. Then I come home one day, and... Where is it?
Where's Big Brother Amazon?
Well, she told me she found out that it could listen in your house, and boop, that was it. It was gone. No more.
That technology is freaky, man.
Well, yeah.
You know,
well, look, I remember, you remember 9/11.
I do.
And there was all the stuff.
Yes, sir.
You know, on the Patriot Act.
Hey,
and
listen, but I was one of them people that was absolutely against that Patriot.
Well, I don't even remember. All I know is I remember saying, if it meant... that John Ashcroft, who was an attorney general, if it meant John Ashcroft was going to look in my bedroom window, if that's what it took to keep Osama bin Laden from nuking me and my family, then, hey,
amen,
Pete, have a peek, bud. Yeah.
And in the pressure of that moment coming out of that,
yeah,
that's to be expected.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah,
people would give up some liberty.
Yeah.
What did Franklin say?
Franklin, well, he said anybody that was willing to give up some freedom for some liberty doesn't deserve either.
But there's a balance,
you know, there
you
is.
Know
you
safety
need a,
and security.
You
it's,
need
it's
about,
required.
They are watching. Look, you live around here. You know people in
we
the
live
intelligence
in DC,
community.
Man.
And I had a friend 25 years ago in the intelligence community say to me, you have no idea of the amount of surveillance they can. You know what it made me think of? I just recently read a biography of George Orwell. And he wrote his dystopian novel, 1984. He
That's
wrote
right.
it in like
That's
the
right.
40s.
That's right.
And
he was dead on, though.
Yeah, but I remember him talking about, you know, they watched everything. And I'll never forget this line
mm-hmm.
where he said, there's only one little corner of your brain that you have to yourself. And you know, if
some days
up,
I don't
might
think
not even have that.
I have even that corner. But the reality is that's basically all you've got left.
Yeah. Oh,
so
yeah.
If you're living with this reality of Big Brother watching you, one of those people on the video just said, hey, I don't care. I'm not doing anything wrong.
Yeah.
What's the problem?
Well, I know, and that's true if you're not doing anything wrong, but there's a certain amount of privacy. I mean,
it's
you know,
be
there's
some,
certain things
you know,
that isn't anybody's blanket
no,
business.
No, and you should be able to function in a society, even if it's an illusion. Give me at least some illusion of the privacy.
I don't know if we have the illusion. I'm just saying, with the stuff they do, the cameras are everywhere.
The reality is it
phone,
probably is just an illusion.
Phone, they could, I even hear they got
all
software
the,
on the phone.
All
they
the data.
They can listen to you on your phone.
Every time.
Somebody could be listening right now.
Right now. I know.
Big Brother's watching. But
Cliff, every time they foil some terrorist, every time they catch some guy that's you know, some white nationalist that's going to mow down, you know, a whole group of people, rest assured that that is the surveillance apparatus at work. We like it when it works great.
It's good and bad. And every time you go to the airport, to get on a plane.
Every time, man. They pat you down,
they pat you down and all that. Hey, but again, I'd rather do that
than to go up and not come down.
Yeah, so.
So there's a trade-off.
It's a trade-off, but you never ultimately know. Where do you cross the line?
Right.
You know, a lot of these totalitarian societies, they didn't get there boom, boom, boom. Just instantly.
No.
It was step by
step. It's incremental.
You get used to it.
Yeah, it's incremental.
You get used to it, boom.
Like frogs in hot water, man, boiling water.
Pretty much anything you ever do, I just assume that what I'm doing online, I'm not saying somebody's watching
you
now.
But if you can do it in front of your mother, you probably shouldn't be doing it. You know what I mean? Like, if you can... If you can't do that, whatever you're doing online in front of your mama, don't do it.
Well, I don't know about that. Okay. I guess that's a good principle. But
Let's go a little wider than that. That might be a bad principle. But Cliff,
I love it. Yeah, that's great.
How do we reconcile that thing, man, with, say, you know, spiritual people, people of faith are like, surveillance, what surveillance? We're under surveillance anyway. God's watching.
Oh, well.
Right?
My Bible's very clear.
What does your Bible say? I don't know. Maybe it says the same thing mine does, but how do you see this thing from like a spiritual perspective? I don't know.
Well, yeah, one of the things I've learned from, go ahead, I got something to say in my throat. But
when I think about it biblically, I think of God being the all-seeing
eye. He sees everything. He's got that little corner.
Even that corner.
That door.
So even the corner.
That Winston Smith, and what was his name? What was the name of the Winston Smith? Nemesis in, I can't believe I forgot.
You have to pull that
one. Well, yeah, I can't believe his name, but he didn't have the corner. But God's got that corner as well. The bottom line is you might be able to hide stuff from the surveillance state. You might be able to hide stuff from your wife. You may be, but you can't hide it from God.
Mercy.
He knows everything.
Oh, boy. So
so if you think the surveillance
is bad, it's bad.
There's a God in heaven who knows everything. And scripture does say, for God will bring every work into judgment,
every secret thing, secret whether it be good or evil.
And that,
which is a sobering, frightening
it should be.
Reality, and it should be.
It's meant to be.
Yeah.
On the other hand.
But then, Cliff, given that reality, man, like, do I just go, like, lay under my bed and never come out? You know what I mean? Like, that could really mess with your concept of living your life in freedom.
You mean about the surveillance?
Yeah, the surveillance state, but also the fear that comes from knowing that God is watching
me. Well, that's where you should do anything your mama wouldn't want you to do in front of your mama.
That's when it counts?
Or God.
Okay, all right. I can see that.
That I can do.
God and my mama, they're the same.
Yeah, that makes a little more sense.
How do you live under this kind of regime, you know, still being free of mind and freedom?
Well, I mean, I just accept we had to give up that we're being watched, you know? And in one sense, unless you really are doing something bad, you know, in one sense, it's not that big of a deal. I mean, I don't like it, but this is just the call. Look, I love my phone.
Right.
How did we live? It was
right.
Before the cell phone and after cell phone. How do you, but you get so much convenience from it. It's so much good. But you're giving something up.
And all of us have to do that to some degree. Social media.
You get on those things. So
to connect with people, you give up some things.
So you got to decide, man.
Here's what I think, though, Cliff.
Well, there's a certain amount you have no choice. I mean, you can get rid of your cell phone.
But how are you going to function, right?
Yeah,
what did we do before cell phones? I don't know.
Don't ask me that. I don't know. As I said, I like to just, you know, BC and AD.
Right.
Cell phones and after cell phones, yeah.
Check this out. I think one of the blessings of the surveillance state is that the life that you live, if you're living right now, this can be used against you, right? But the life that you live, there's an opportunity to show.
Okay.
To be an example.
Okay.
So yeah, I'm operating online, I'm in social media, you know, I'm kicking it back and forth with my phone.
You can do good.
But the way that I use it and what I do with it is also a witness, isn't it?
Yeah.
Isn't that an opportunity?
I guess it's like with anything, it could be used for good
or for
bad. I mean, I often think after the Wright brothers, I remember that. Whatever year they first flew, within like 12 years or something, the first airplane.
Yeah.
The first bomb was dropped. Wow. From an airplane. Within 12, Wright brothers fly amazing, but in some Italian-Turkish war.
So every technology, no matter how great it is at the outset.
Italian-Turkish war, some guy flew over, I think in a Turkish camp with Italian or what, vice versa. I think it was an Italian dropping it. Mm-hmm. He had a hand grenade.
And he dropped
and
it
he flew over and he threw it out of the
dropped
airplane.
Dropped it out the plane.
So that's the technology's good. But it's, you know, it can be used on the flip
because
side.
Because its subject is always to man's heart, which is broken, which is sinful, which has issues.
And that's why the thought, you know, before I was believed in God, every now and then, I remember I was in college, mm-hmm. and every now and then I'd think, well, you know, maybe there was
You were
some,
having a thought you know, in college.
Yeah. Maybe there was some big mama or some big daddy up
in
there.
In the sky.
I used to push it away.
Yeah.
Because don't ask me why, for some reason, I had this sense, if there was somebody up there.
Yes, sir.
I'm in deep trouble.
Because he's watching and he's recording.
I had to sense.
And some things are coming. Some things are coming back.
Yeah, I wasn't a bad, you know, quote bad. I didn't do really quote.
Right.
You know, I was working. I went to college.
But you're not a believer in anything.
Yeah, back then I didn't.
But you have this inkling.
I had this sense. So think though. I mean, to me, if Scripture is clear about anything,
it's clear about this.
There's a God who knows everything,
and he's watching.
There's gonna be a judgment. And people are going to have that. So, hey, whether you like it or
You didn't just say the J word, though.
There is a God, and one day all those
Nobody
nasty,
wants to be in judgment.
Yeah, and have those nasty, dirty little things think anybody sees.
Cliff.
He knows.
I got.
But there's some good news.
But I got a remedy for that.
Amen.
I got a remedy for that. And that remedy is his son.
Well, that's why we understand it, yeah.
He came. He lived a life. He put a perfect life on the books. And he says to us, all you have to do is accept me and believe.
Yeah, well, that's,
and I'll
put
cover
it this
you.
Way. I've been a believer for 40 years, and the thought of the judgment, the only hope I have.
Come on now.
The only hope I have whenever is that he stands in my stead as promised in the judgment. So.
And his life covering my life.
Because without it, my life.
Are you going to take. Who wants to take their chances?
Well, you know, this is every secret thing. I'm in trouble for what I've done in public. The secret stuff?
Yeah,
the
but
secret,
Cliff,
oh man.
What about the very
Well, in the
motivations
thought, yeah, that's what I'm saying. The little hidden corner that, you know.
The stuff that's been up there.
Yeah, that Winston
well,
Smith
Cliff,
thought he had for himself.
I know you're better than me. I'm pretty sure you're like
I probably am.
Super
probably
Christian.
Am. I mean,
I'm going to give it to you. I'm going to give it to you. Flat out. But I know I got some stuff.
Of course, who doesn't?
And
we all got some heavy
baggage. We all got some stuff. And the best thing we could do, man, is, you know, teach us to number our days that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom, you know, work out your stuff with fear and trembling. It's like you need to really have this conversation and think seriously about what your life is. Not just because the conversation is being pushed.
Big brother's watching.
Yeah.
Not because that's small.
That's small brother. That's little brother.
Yeah.
The real big brother.
Well, I don't know. I like to look at God as real big brother. Because
that's
so
true,
negative.
That's true. But
negative.
That big brother loves us.
Yeah. That's the difference. That big brother
that
wants the best for us.
Yeah.
And if you look at it that way. Yeah. You look at it that way.
It's
well,
not so bad.
Again, it can be scary. It's not scary because of my belief in the substitute in the judgment. But the thought of having to be in that judgment
without a mediator or an advocate is a little frightening.
You're dead meat. You're dead meat. There's no question about it.
We ain't just talking peanuts when it comes to that.
No.
That's real stuff. And I'm telling you, we got an opportunity, bless God, not just to live in this world and be scared, man, but to live with purpose and to live with peace. I don't know about you. I live in D.C., the politics is thick. People are at each other's throats. I just want a little bit of peace.
Yeah, I think we all do.
The thought of Big Brother bothers me, but what you said about that faith in Christ, man, is real. I think I'm ready, dude. What you got? Do you have something greasy that will stop his heart? Don't give it to him.
Yeah. I need something vegan. Something not my mother would want me to
eat. There you go. His mama.
My mother would want me.